In the last video, we discussed about planetary conjunctions and also about the elongations of inner planets. We see Venus many times in the evening sky as a very bright object. When it is there, usually after sun and moon, it is the third brightest object in the sky. So we can, it is easily identifiable, like we can see in the screenshot here. Venus, in fact, Venus and Jupiter both are shown. And this object as a very bright object was noticed by ancients as well. So in all cultures, Venus is known as morning star or evening star. So why the same object Venus sometimes appears as morning star, sometimes as evening star? So let's look at the example. Here we will see the sky moving. Venus is there in the sky just before sunrise and then sun rises. So this is, in this case, people will call it morning star. What exactly is happening? If you look at the orbit of Venus and orbit of Earth, we will see, take this position. The yellow triangle shows position of observer. Here what do we observe? That this observer's horizon is shown by this dashed white line. Now we can see, as Earth is rotating around its position, first Venus comes above horizon and then Sun comes above horizon. Same is shown in the left panel. You can check, as the dashed line crosses Venus, the Venus comes above horizon and then Sun comes above horizon. So this is the position typically before sunrise. Now can you imagine what will happen if Earth was on and Venus were on the other side? It will be exactly the opposite position. We see Venus in the evening sky. For example, here just after the sunset on in the western side, you can see the Venus setting just after the sunset. And if you want to draw a diagram, it will look like this. The horizon first crosses Sun and then crosses Venus, and we see Venus just setting after the sunset. Now, we in the conjunctions video, we also mentioned, repeatedly mentioned, that when the inner planets come between Earth and Sun, we say between, that is, if you take the Earth's plane around Sun as the horizontal plane, then they cross the vertical plane connecting Earth and Sun. The inner planets cross the vertical plane connecting Earth and Sun, but they are not necessarily in the same line. So every infinite conjunction, they are somewhere in between, but they may be slightly above, slightly below, or may be in the same line. Obviously, when they will be in same line, that is a special position, we call that as the transit of these inner planets. So here is an example of transit of Mercury. We can see Mercury moving as a black dot on the solar disk. This is a photograph taken, okay, over multiple exposures, so you can see the path of. Now, similar to Mercury, you will also see transit of Venus, but less often. Mercury transits you will see every couple of years, but Venus transits you will only see in like twice every 100 years. So if one Venus transit occurs, the next one will happen after 8 years, but the one after that will happen after more than 100 years. So Venus transits are kind of special. The other special thing is, as Venus is much closer to us, from different places on Earth, the path of Venus on solar disk appears to be significantly different. There is also a difference in the path of Mercury as we see from different places, but that difference is much smaller. For in case of Venus, the difference is much significant, and in fact, that was used to calculate distance of Venus, exact distance of Venus from Earth. So during the Venus transit of 19th century, people actually measured the path of Venus as seen from two different latitudes along almost same longitude, and that was used to find distance to Venus. Here, for example, a cartoon shows that if you take two locations A and B on surface of Earth, for them the Venus may appear to trace the paths A prime and B prime, you can show, they are shown here, and this difference is used to measure this angle and hence the distance to Venus. In case of all these planets, they are much closer to us as compared to other bodies. So, when they are going around Sun, sometimes they can block the objects which are behind them, sometimes stars, sometimes other planets. Most common example is Moon. Moon is very close to us, it also is quite big in this size. So, routinely as it is going around Earth, it will cover some stars or some planets. So, for example, here this is a very special picture, there is an eclipsed moon. So, you can see it reddish color, and just on the edge here is planet Uranus, which is about to go behind the lunar disk. So, this is taken exactly at time when the it was going to go behind the lunar disk. This is called as occultation of Uranus by Moon. So, the object which is getting covered, occultation of that object by other object. Here in case of Moon, occultation by Moon, but we can also see occultation by asteroids, we can sometimes also see occultation by other planets, but those are much more rarer. So, another example of Moon occulting Saturn. Here you can see there is some lighter part of Moon, this dark part of Moon, and Saturn is going behind a dark part of Moon. So, the rings are getting cut because part of the rings are already behind the lunar disk. There is a time lapse photos. If you can see, Saturn is coming out from behind, and you can see more and more parts of Saturn as it comes out. Another thing which is true for outer planets is that we see a very peculiar motion from the outer planets in the sky, what we call as retrograde motion. What we mean by retrograde? Retrograde is going backwards. When we are sitting in a car, and if a faster car overtakes, from the point of view of faster car, the other car seem to be going behind. Similar thing happens. So, let us take a simplified model. I have drawn orbit of Earth here and orbit of Mars. For the simple model, I am taking both the orbits to be perfectly coplanar and they circular. What I am going to do is, few days before the opposition of Mars, I will start plotting position of Earth and position of Mars every 10 days. And then I would draw a line connecting Earth and Mars, which will tell me where the Mars would appear in front of the stellar background, which is a distant line which I have drawn. So, let us go and see this. I start day 0, the position. So, Earth is here, Mars is here, and we see the position of Mars on the stellar background as position A. 10 more days, B, C, D, and so on. Every 10 days is the position. As you can see, the difference between C and D is very small. 10 more days and you will see something different. Remember, Earth is also going ahead in the orbit, Mars is also going ahead in the orbit, but Earth is going faster. Now, what we are going to see, next three positions E, F and G. You can actually see that Mars was going this way, now it is going towards the right of your screen. The G position is the opposition position for Mars. This is where exact opposition is. Continue for ahead, H, I, J, 10 more days each, it is still going further back. Then K, L, M, now it has started going towards left again. So its backward motion is complete and forward motion has started. This is called retrograde motion. In this case, where orbits are coplanar and circular, what we are going to see is just a single line in the sky. Mars is traveling in one line this way, then coming back, just overriding on the same line, and then going back, going ahead again. But in reality, the orbits are not circular or coplanar. So if you look in the sky, for example, you would see, and if you plot positions of Mars, sometimes you may see the loop like this. These loops are different for different cases. I will show you another example. So in this cartoon, for example, Mars's orbit is shown slightly above Earth's orbit to begin with, but towards the end it is almost coming to the Earth's orbit. In such case, what you will see, Earth is shown, Mars is shown, they are both moving in the right direction, and you will see that it is tracing a loop like this. Another case, you would see here now, I will play this animation. You watch Jupiter as well as Mars. You can see Jupiter is moving towards left of your screen, Mars also moving. Mars is going faster obviously because it is closer. Now here Jupiter has stopped and started going backwards. There now Mars has stopped and Mars has also started going backwards. Jupiter is continuing backward motion. Now Jupiter has stopped backward motion, it is continuing ahead. Mars also has stopped backward motion, it is going ahead. You can see they both trace different kinds of loop which depend on where they are in the orbit and what is the inclination. So you can see many such loops, and based on the size and shape of loop, we can predict exactly how the orbits are inclined to each other and how their eccentricities are. So this way, if you go beyond the circular orbit, you can come up with many interesting situations, and modeling these situations will tell you a lot about motions of planets in our solar system. Thank you.